Hello children, I hope you all are fine and spending quality time with your family members. Today I am going to give you a short explanation on lesson number 1, that is building with bricks. I have divided this chapter into 3 subdivisions. They are first cubes and cuboids, second is floor and wall patterns, and the third one is the unitary method. Now in this slide you can see a cube. Properties of a cube are: all its faces are square in shape. It has 6 faces, 8 vertices and 12 edges. An example of a cube is a dice which we use while playing Ludo or Snake and Ladders. The next slide shows you the picture of a cuboid. Properties of a cuboid are: faces of a cuboid are rectangular. It has 6 faces, 8 vertices and 12 edges. Examples of cuboid are bricks, books and shoe boxes. We will be focusing more on the bricks. In this slide, you can see a brick with 3 faces. We all know that bricks are used for construction of walls. These walls are in turn converted into houses, buildings, and apartments. Now, this slide shows you the different methods of arranging the bricks for making walls. Look carefully, children. You can see how beautifully the bricks have been laid down. At times we leave gaps while making the wall. These are known as the jali patterns. Here in this slide you can see some examples. You can see how beautifully a pattern has been created. This slide shows a small opening in a wall which is known as the jharoka. They are usually built for ventilation, for the sunlight and the air to get in. Some buildings, especially old monuments, have windows with an arch which make them look beautiful. This slide shows you some windows with an arch. Other than walls, bricks are also laid down on the floor. These are known as floor patterns. This slide shows some of the floor patterns. These are the symmetrical floor patterns. Children, look carefully. You can see how beautifully the bricks have been laid down. Other than the symmetrical pattern, in this slide you can see that the bricks have been laid down in a circular pattern. Now I come to the third part of the chapter, that is the unitary method. When we solve any problem using the unitary method, we make use of 2 mathematical operations. One is multiplication and the other is division. When you know about one and you have to find out about many, we multiply. The example is, if the cost of 1 pen is rupees 5, find the cost of 7 pens. That means if I buy 1 pen, I am supposed to pay 5 rupees. So how much will you pay if you want 7 pens? So the solution is, since the cost of 1 pen is rupees 5, therefore cost of 7 pens is 7 multiplied by 5, or 5 multiplied by 7, either way it is correct, is equal to rupees 35. The second example is, if one bus carries 55 people, how many people will 6 buses carry? Solution is, one bus carries 55 people, therefore 6 buses will carry 55 multiplied by 6, that is 330 people. Now in this slide you can see that when you know about many and you have to find out about one, we divide. It is just the opposite of what we have done in the previous slide. The example is, if the cost of 5 books is rupees 100, find the cost of 1 book. That means I bought 5 books, I paid rupees 100. So what should be the cost of 1 book? So solution is, since the cost of 5 books is rupees 100, therefore cost of 1 book is 100 divided by 5, that is rupees 20. Another example I am quoting here is, if the cost of 10 tickets is rupees 350, what will be the cost of 1 ticket? The solution is, since the cost of 10 tickets is equal to rupees 350, therefore cost of 1 ticket is rupees 350 divided by 10, that is rupees 35. Going one step ahead of the unitary method. Now in this example, we will be making use of both the mathematical operations. The question says, The cost of 10 tickets is rupees 350. Find the cost of 15 tickets. I know the cost of 10 tickets and I have to find the cost of 15 tickets. Now to find the cost of 15 tickets, we need to find the cost of one ticket first. So the solution says, since the cost of 10 tickets is equal to rupees 350, therefore cost of one ticket is equal to 350 divided by 10, that is rupees 35. Now as we know the cost of one ticket, now we can find the cost of any number of tickets. The solution is, since the cost of one ticket is equal to rupees 35, therefore cost of 15 tickets is equal to 15 multiplied by 35, that is rupees 525. I hope you all have understood the chapter. In case you have any doubt, please feel free to contact your subject teacher. Thank you and have a nice day.